It's like Boozer says, I hear a bunk calling my name. That should do it.
You need something?
You got something to say about it?
I saw something. Who's that? Men coming!
Come on! Move! move up! What you running for?
Finally. Okay. Always need scrap. Got it. Sniper ambush on the road, damn it.
He got it!
The bastard! He killed him!
That asshole, I guess you won't be ambushing anyone else today. Yeah.
Need this?
Down you go!
Not so hard. Got it. That did it. Fix this. Let's go.
All right, I'm here.
Jesus, don't sneak up on me like that.
Did you find anything out about Sarah, about the woman that I put on your chopper?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Hey, wait, it's gonna take some time, okay? I'm risking my neck here. If anyone back at HQ finds out, those guys with the guns over there,
they're all the same team, O'Brien.
It just looks that way. Look, I don't have time to explain it right now, but it's why I need your help.
My help?
Look, just take it. It's a wavelength recorder and some GPS trackers. I just need you to... We're out of time. Look, I don't even know your name.
Deacon St. John.
Look, Deacon St. John, if you want me to risk my neck helping you find whatever her name, Sarah, then yeah, I'm gonna need you to do something for me. Keep the radio close. I'll contact you in a couple of minutes.
You don't even know my name? Well, you're gonna know it before we're done, O'Brien. And keep the radio close. It's been right here the whole time, you son of a bitch. Jesus Christ, how long do I have to wait now?
Hello? Are you there, Deacon?
Yeah, I'm here. Now, what's this all about? What do you want?
All right, I put a blocker on this channel. It's secure.
What do you want?
I've sent a series of coordinates to your radio. I need you to go to those locations.
What? Why? Then why don't you ask them?
I can't. Look, I said it's a long story, and I don't have time to get into it right now. Let's just say the men above me, way above me, are running a lot of field missions, all separate from each other. Nobody knows what anyone else is doing.
So the world ends, and you assholes carry on like nothing's changed. Where?
I sent you the coordinates.
Okay, Jesus, O'Brien. All right, I will see what I can do.
LZs, landing sites, sample drop-off locations.
Yeah, I got it, but you better have something for me, O'Brien.
Yeah, I got it too. Hold on.
Yeah, I'm here. What do you,
One of our helos is heading towards your position now. You have to follow it.
Follow it? Why?
Just go! Don't lose it.
Jesus, okay. All right. What's going on, O'Brien? Why am I out here in the shit chasing choppers down for you?
Their destination's classified. I'm locked out of their files. So I can't give you the coordinates to their LZ. You have to follow them in.
Jesus, don't you guys have spy satellites? Shit like that?
Not that I have access to, no. I told you.
Locked out. Yeah, I heard you.
Don't lose them.
Come on now. Can't let him get too far ahead. Gotta slow him down.
Brian, they're landing!
Good. I have their coordinates now via your radio. You better go in on foot.
On foot?
Remember, you can't let them see you.
O'Brien, I'm here. What do you want me to do?
Each of these research units have a science guy, like me, guarded by a bunch of goons. We need you to get close to the researcher. The wavelength recorder is set to the channel we use to record data. It'll record everything they're doing.
Okay, so you want me to sneak into an LZ filled with heavily armed Kevlar-wearing soldiers who shoot on sight so that you can spy on some asshole wearing a pocket protector?
Pocket protector? Really? I have a fucking PhD, asshole.
Yeah, which stands for piled high and deep.
Do you still have the tracking devices I gave you?
Well, I was gonna sell them, but most of us don't have access to shit like, you know, satellites.
Place one of them on their helo. Almost all of these filed missions include stops that aren't on the books. I want to find out where they're going next.
O'Brien.
You don't need to ask. I'm already looking into what records we have about where evacuees were taken. O'Brien out.
This just gotta be it. What the hell are you guys doing out here?
Says we're done. Wonder how long this will take.
Too damn long. That's how long.
Hey, I'm losing the light.
It's fine. We'll be gone before it gets dark.
Looks like Field 207.
Jet.
Checking the traps at Site 14 Alpha. I've confirmed a large male subject with a confirmed albinism mutation. Subject has expected lack of skin pigmentation and reddish eyes. Muscle mass appears to be 40% greater than normal infected subjects. What was it you called them? Bleachers. Well, they're real. Well, this is only the third subject we've been able to study. As noted, their strength and ability to absorb damage make them extremely dangerous to approach. We've noted in other field reports that over 1,000 have been spotted in this area. Whatever is causing the mutation, it's spreading rapidly.
What the hell, O'Brien?
What's wrong?
I'll tell you what's wrong. Your boys were carving out the guts of a freak while it was still alive.
They're not my boys. And what do you care? Aren't you a... What do you guys like to call yourselves? Drifters? Don't you kill the infected for money or whatever shit you barter with?
Yeah, I kill freaks, but I don't carve them open while they're still alive and listen to them scream.
Did you get my data?
Yeah, I got your data.
Okay, I'm uploading it now. I'll be in touch. O'Brien out.
Brian,
O'Brien. Ah, God damn it, he did it again. O'Brien, talk to me. Ah, shit, you better be in touch, O'Brien.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It's with a heavy heart that I report 6 deaths and 2 injuries from my camp this week. Not from the usual shit. No. It was those damn black choppers. Let me tell you, everything I've been warning you about is absolutely coming true. Where those choppers touched down, wiped out an entire group of men and women who were screaming and begging for mercy. Citizens of this country. And they cut them down. My men returned fire, but... shit! This won't be the last we hear of them either. They're hunting us down. Those of us who dare to survive and mess with their plans. Finally emerge from their gopher holes. Stay vigilant, people. And keep your eyes on the sky. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Hey, I came by to see how the lazy bastard's doing. How you doing, Booze Man? Are you tired of laying around yet? Boozer.
Hey, you can't be in here, Deacon.
Come on, hey,
come
what's
on,
going
Deacon.
On? How's he doing?
He needs his rest.
Don't mess around with me, Addy. I asked you, how is he doing?
I'm good.
Not good.
Damn, it's cold.
They're not enough.
Never enough.
No, wait a second. You said that
I said that we would try. Look, all we can do is wait.
Okay. All right.
Deacon.
There's... You know what? There's something I can do about this.
Stop.
I can get...
Stop!
What?
I know you want to smash something. I see that look in your eyes. But you know what? You go right ahead, but you do it out there.
Addy.
Go.
I can...
Look. There is nothing else you can do.
Get it.
Please. Just go home. Go home, Deacon.
Deacon.
So, you gonna make it?
Yeah, Schizo, he'll be fine. He needs a few days.
Come with me to the lodge. I wanna show you something.
I got shit to do.
I'm sticking my neck out here. Trust me. You're gonna wanna see this. Just listen. A couple of months back, this drifter comes into camp. Telling all kind of crazy stories. Said he worked at the airport, was on the ground back in Farewell when shit went down. One night, they were expecting a flight in from Portland, only it never shows up. The plane was doing a haul for the Red Cross.
The Red Cross?
Yeah.
A few weeks back,
you getting it?
We were riding
medicine,
along
doctor shit,
road,
cargo hold full of it. Maybe even some of those whatever
naked,
the fucks.
Scarred up.
Antibiotics.
Took a knife.
Yeah. So shit like that. Just like that.
They were rippers.
Where?
A cult over
hey, keep your voice down, will you? Let's talk inside.
They worship.
So this drifter, he's working in the control tower when the plane disappears off the radar. Poof. Now you see it, now you don't. Right about here.
South of Mount Washington.
That's what he said. It came down intact. A controlled crash or whatever. The guy's got to listen to the pilot bleeding out from a broken pelvis on the ground.
Okay, so you haven't sent anyone to find this?
Nope.
Why not?
Because the old man won't have it.
Iron Mike, what's... Oh, right. Rippers.
You catch on quick. Everything west of the Iron Ridge here belongs to Carlos and his merry band of bald-headed freak-alikes.
Shit.
So you go over there and you get caught, you head north, brother. Otherwise, Iron Mike's treaty with Rest in Peace goes...
I get it. Let me ask you a question. Why are you telling me this?
Wait a minute. First off, I'm not telling you shit. You remember that? Second off, you're a goddamn drifter. What am I supposed to do? Follow you around like I'm your little bitch, keep your ass out of trouble?
All right.
I have things to do.
I get it. You're just a regular stand-up guy, right, Schizo?
Just trying to stay alive. Like everybody else. Hey. You do what you gotta do. At the end of the day, that's all we got. Do you know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying, Schizo.
Keep your radio close. I'll be in touch.
Schizo, we can always count on you.
Shit, now what?
Anything's better than standing around this shithole.
Funny. We used to love it out here. My husband and I would bring the kids every time.
Hey there.
Hey, how's it going?
Okay. Yeah, good. Now that's an upgrade. Yep, that's nice. All right. Hey, see ya.
You here for your bike?
Just looking around.
All right, I got you. Later, Deke.
Be here late.
Try to make Trevor a day or two, will ya?
Looking to buy, Hope.
Let me get the gate.
Hey, St. John, you there?
Yeah, Schizo, I'm here.
Now that business we were talking about, it's gonna take me a bit. I gotta go check on security at the border with Iron Butte. Check on the Rippers there, if you know what I mean.
No, Schizo, I don't got a clue. Why don't you spell it out for me?
Nice try, smartass. Remember, I'm going out on a limb here. Don't make me regret it. Anyway, I'll be in touch real soon. In the meantime, make yourself useful around camp. Prove Iron Mike was right for a change.
Yeah, sure. Whatever you say. Whatever you say. St. John out.
St. John, where you at, brother?
I'm here, Schizo, but I'm not your goddamn brother.
Hey, no skin off my nose. Just doing what I can to help you, bro. That business we discussed? Let's just say, you should head out that way now.
Oh, you mean the border with the Rippers?
Very funny. I meant no such thing. All I said was, if you were thinking about taking a ride, or what do you drifters like to call it, riding the open road, now would be a good time to do it. You got me?
Yeah, Schizo, like always, I got you.
St. John out.
Got you. Fresh meat. Gotta take a closer look. All right, where? There you are. Deer crossing. It's not too smart.
This is it. Okay, let's see. What's going on here?
Open up, don't get all day.
My first one. Hey there. I was
where?
Last day it turned out.
What's going on? Hey, I saw Boozer the other day. Your friend, right? See ya.
Hey.
Hey, Blair, how's life?
Yep. Lips pulled back, baring her teeth like I don't know. Now that's an upgrade. Yep. Hey.
Jumped on this.
See ya.
A college kid. Start tearing his throat.
What do you need?
Nope.
Is this enough stew?
I could do something. That's it for now.
Someone's here. Men coming!
Nice bunch of rapists, thieves, and murderers. What you doing out here, huh? You looking for your next easy target?
Where the hell did he go?
Okay, here we go.
Schizo, it's St. John. I'm at the border.
You see any of my men around?
No, Schizo, it's clear. Look, how much time do I got?
Time? Time for what? All I know is I got a card game going on with a few of my guys. A couple of them maybe they should be out on guard duty, but I'm letting that slide. If I had to guess, I'd say we'd be playing all night.
So until morning. Got it, Deacon out.
How you know?
He is now free.
Ah.
you can't.
Yeah.
Better than nothing. You don't need these.
you to back! Hey, still coming.
There's gotta be some here.
Son of a bitch!
Basil fix him up, and then we ride out of here, head north, like he said.
St. John, you there? Deke, this is Ricky. Over.
Damn it, I can't let her know I'm out here. Hey, Ricky?
This is Deke. You're breaking up. I can't hear you.
Deke, where are you? I need to get...
Oh, God. Sorry, Ricky. I don't have time for this right now.
Wait! That's Deacon! Behind him! You! Right up the road, make sure they don't come back. Now!
Run him down!
What was left of him, yeah.
What was left of him?
Hey, I heard gunshots. What's going on?
We had a run-in with a few rippers, but I handled it.
You handled it. What the... Wow. I should have known.
You should have known what? Jesus, Ricky, who's running security here?
You know, I ask myself that shit every single day.
I'm done here.
Good.
So what are you doing out here?
What am I doing, Dick? Addie told me to come and get you.
Why? What... Hold on for a second. Is Boozer okay?
I don't know. We gotta go.
What's wrong with Boozer?
All I know is Addie told me to find you. When I asked around, I found out you and Schizo were heading up here. Now I know why.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The crash site? The medical supplies? It's no big secret, Deke. Iron Mike was negotiating with Carlos, making a deal so our camp would split it with the Rippers.
Oh, bullshit!
What do you mean?
I mean bullshit! I was there! Had that cargo hold's already been looted. Tracks from the crash site all head south. You know, I've been dealing with the fucking Rippers for months. You can't trust a goddamn thing they say.
Now you're sounding like Schizo. Schizo, he put you up to this. He told you about the crash site.
Yeah, great! So now you're calling me Schizo's errand boy.
No? Then how'd you find out about it?
A drifter up at Copeland's camp. Like you said, it ain't no big secret.
Yeah, right. Well, Schizo's been trying to pick a fight with the Rippers for months. Guess it's lucky you came along to do it for him. So let me ask you something.
Can I stop you?
Last time I saw you, before last winter, you told Iron Mike to go fuck himself because he wouldn't pay you to bring in survivors.
It's not exactly what happened.
I remember it pretty clearly. Iron Mike said he'd have nothing to do with slavers.
Okay, we never forced anyone to come in against their will.
How about Tucker? Same thing true for her?
I don't know.
You ever think when you roll up on someone, starving out in the shit, maybe hasn't slept in days, reach the point where they stop running from men like you, you ever think they don't have a choice? But you took them to the hot springs just the same. Earn a few camp credits. Everybody's got a choice, Deacon. It takes us a lot, too, bringing in someone who can't work, can't earn their way. You know, you just be glad that Iron Mike isn't like you.
William! William, if you can hear me, I need you to stop!
Addie, what's going on?
Boozer?
Go and hold him.
What the hell are you doing?
Listen,
what are you doing?
Listen, we need to do this, and we need to do this right now.
You what?
No!
Don't you take it!
No, no. No, you're not. No way. No, you're not going to do this.
Deacon, listen to me. The antibiotics will save his life, but nothing on God's earth is going to save the arm. Now listen, I need you to help me right now, or you can just watch your friend die.
Okay. Andy, we're losing him.
Stay away.
Deacon.
All right. All right, all right.
Come on.
Hey, pal. Hey, pal. All right, hey, I just need you to stay
hold
with
him.
Me.
Hold him there.
Okay.
Hold him.
Deke.
Okay. Hold him down right there.
Okay.
Ah! Ah! Oh, my goodness. Ah! Damn it, we're losing him.
No. He's losing too much blood. You gotta stop. He's losing too much blood.
Hand me the ball.
No. Boozer, come on, man. Come on.
Hold him.
You're okay, pal. Where? Where do I hold him?
Just hold him like this. Stop panicking.
I'm trying.
Hey. You did good in there.
When I was in high school, I thought, maybe I should be a mechanical engineer. Or should I be a surgeon? I guess I should have been a surgeon.
And you.
Hey, okay.
You know, you saved your friend's life today.
I don't think he's gonna see it that way.
Yeah, well, I think he will. I gotta go and give him his IV drip. And you know what? I don't know where you got all this, and I don't want to know. But it's gonna save a lot of lives, Deacon St. John. A lot of lives.
I gotta go help Addy.
Mike, just settle down, okay?
Deacon! Get out here! I heard what you did.
Wasn't about to let him die.
Mike, let it go. It's done.
I know that, goddammit. Boozer gonna live?
I don't know.
But the Ripper saw you. Followed you back. When Carlos finds out about this, there's gonna be the devil to pay.
Carlos can go fuck himself!
You are writing checks with other men's blood! I hope you're good with that.
You did what had to be done. Mike, wait up.
What's going on? Yep.
I wonder about the freakers sometimes, you know? Like, do they feel pain? Anything?
What do you need?
You got a problem?
That's all I got for now.
Hey there.
Hey, how's it going?
Yep. Here you go. That should work. Okay. You would come back soon, huh?
Oh, I'm just gonna close my eyes for a bit. I'm ready to go back at it. I'm just gonna grab some shot eye. All right, okay, let's go.
Lake to Deacon St. John. Are you there?
Yeah, Ricky, what's up?
Iron Mike says you volunteered to stick around, do some runs for the camp, but that you refused to work for Schizo.
Yeah, something like that.
Well, I can't say I blame you. Okay, well, I guess I'm stuck with you. So stop by the mechanic shop, we've got a job for you.
Yeah, okay. Deacon out. Deacon St. John to Lost Lake Infirmary. Come back.
Deke!
Hey. Feeling a little out of it, you know. You okay? What's going on?
Boozer. O'Brien, I'm at one of your beacons.
Which one?
What do you mean, which one? This Nero radio has a GPS, doesn't it?
Yes, of course it does. Okay. You're at Olali Falls. Okay, good. Keep an eye out. A field op is going to be there any minute. O'Brien out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it. O'Brien, come in. Your friends are here. O'Brien.
They're not my friends. Okay, head in on foot.
Yeah, I know. What do you want me to do?
I need
one of these tracking devices.
Come on, folks.
No, not this time. I'm already tracking this one.
Let me know when it's clear.
Follow the researcher, and she's there to investigate an infected subject, the freak that was tagged in a nearby cave.
A cave? You want me to follow armed Nero goons into a cave?
Close to her. While you're in range, I can intercept.
Brian.
I'm still working on the info you want. Don't ask.
Why the hell am I talking to you?
Oh, Brian out.
Sound off. All good here. Locked down.
Looks good to me. LZ secure?
All clear, Doc.
Stay close to her, right
yeah.
Over Ann.
I never got that.
That was
easier said than done.
Stage one, stage two, stage three thing.
What do you mean?
I mean, the virus is what it is, right?
No, it's more complicated than that. Now let me...
Okay. I know I'm a grunt. Before the freak show, I was a biology major. Just give me the gist.
Really?
Try me.
Okay. We don't really know, but blood tests show. The current evidence suggests that the virus spreads through the lymph system, reproducing and attacking cells on a catastrophic scale.
Attacking?
More precisely, expressing a series of normally dormant proto-oncogenes into an active state.
Cancer.
Look at him. Look at all of them. That look like cancer to you?
Maybe you're really bad.
No. No, no, this is something far worse.
What do you mean?
This virus is on a mission. The freaks are what they are because the virus wants them that way.
What are you saying?
I'm saying... Jesus, what am I saying?
Terrorism? You're saying this was deliberate?
I don't know.
Is that it? Is she done? Yeah, okay. Time to get the hell out of Dodge.
Whatever the hell it is.
What it's doing.
I want to know what the hell's going on, O'Brien. Why are they out here? What the fuck are you doing? O'Brien?
Okay. I'll be in touch. O'Brien out.
Oh, boy, this is going to be fast. Hey, Ricky, you said you had a job for me?
Hey, Deke. Yeah,
You remember Shane Riley? Everyone called him Red.
Red Riley. Yeah, never heard of him, but let me guess. Ginger?
But red hair? No. It was his boots. He wore these rattlesnake boots dyed with god-awful red color. He made quite the impression.
No, I bet.
Anyway, he used to do runs for us back in the day until one day he decides he didn't like the camp credits we were paying. So he up and kills Lindsay Fuller.
Who?
Lindsay. Worked supply before Blair.
Wait a second, so he killed an unarmed woman?
Oh, she was armed. She just wasn't expecting him to shoot her in the face. Will you listen? So Red murders her, cleans out her supply hut, and then takes off before anyone knows what's happened. Got away clean.
Oh, that son of a bitch.
Until now. He and his men have been spotted up at Camp Pioneer.
You don't gotta ask. I got this thing about him.
About killing unarmed women. I know. So I knew you'd want to handle it.
Yeah, like I said, I got this covered. What else can you tell me about him?
Not much. Oh, wait. He chews tobacco. I heard he was such an addict that he rounds up cigarette butts, takes out the tobacco, and chews that.
Well, that's disgusting. So now I got two reasons to kill him.
Yeah, but be careful, Deke.
Hey, man.
Hey, how's it going?
Looking for anything in particular? You go through a lot of this shit, yeah? I'll be here if you need me. Later.
Hey, man. Hello.
Nice, good haul.
That's all I got.
Hello.
Hey, Blair.
Good one. That should work. All right. Whatever you need, I got it. Yep. You would come back soon, huh?
It's like Boozer says, I hear a bunk calling my name. That should do it.
Hey, man.
Ricky, what's up?
I just wanted to say I'm sorry about what happened to Boozer.
Yeah, probably not as sorry as he is.
Look, Addy wanted you to know that if you hadn't brought her that list of knife, Boozer would be in a hell of a lot more pain right now.
Yeah, well, it just made it easier for you to carve him up.
Anyway, we hope he makes it. He's my friend too, you know?
Hey, listen, thanks for bringing us in, Ricky. I gotta go. Deacon out. Addy, you there? Deacon St. John to Lost Lake Infirmary. Come back.
Deke! Hey, feeling a little out of it, you know. You okay? What's going on?
Boozer. Hey, nothing. I got tired of listening to the radio-free Oregon. Can only take so much of his truth or bullshit, you know?
Deke, Addy told me how I'd be dead if it weren't for you. Getting the NI, whatever the fuck, so.
Boozer,
it must have been fun. Holding me down while she fucking whacked away at me. Remember how Jack carved up that turkey last time we was all together? It kept slipping all over the goddamn table.
Yeah, Booze Man. I remember.
I still feel it, you know? Knife. Worse than the Rippers. If you hadn't been there to hold me down, I don't know what would have happened, Deke. I don't know.
Well, it's done, Boozer. It's done. It's... Hey, Ricky, I'm at Camp Pioneer, and it is a goddamn war zone.
What's going on? Are any of our guys there?
No, I don't think so. Sounds like they're clearing freaks. Don't worry.
Damn it.
I'll find this guy. Deacon out.
I thought I saw someone.
There we go.
All right, Red. Where the hell are you? Newts. Oh, wow, they're killing newts. Okay, what's this? Okay, yes, yes, cigarette butts, yes.
Freaks!
These look like the kind of prints that some fancy cowboy boots would make.
That's it.
Someone's here. Who's that?
Motherfucker. More boot prints. Yeah, this way. What's in here?
Gotta move.
Men coming.
Yeah, not bad.
Saw something. What was that?
Men coming!
Drink one of these, you son of a bitch!
Yeah, burn him!
What the hell? He's here somewhere.
Just what?
You gotta stop moving somehow.
See ya! Yeah!
Oh, good. Urine. Jesus.
Well, if you gotta go, you gotta go.
Yeah.
fuck are you hiding, Red? He's gotta be here somewhere.
I see you running around.
Oh, no!
You gotta move! Open fire!
He killed him!
You gotta pull back.
Pulling back!
Here you are.
Mine now.
Think you can get through all this? Huh? Got him!
Moving, yeah?
He's not moving! Shut him!
Burn, you asshole.
Hiding in one of these shacks, huh?
She had it coming. The one that I shot, she's mouthing off to me.
Ooh, there he is.
See, really? No. I don't take shit off her. No. I told her, shut the hell up. I'm gonna shoot you in the face. You listen to me? No. No one ever fucking listens to me. Now. No one gonna disrespect Red Riley and walk away. Sir. Well, I mean, she don't hear me, does she? She ain't got no goddamn head left.
Use this.
Hey, Ricky, I got him.
Deacon, what a relief. Lindsay has some folks she was close to. I'll let him know.
Yeah, okay. I'll see you around, Ricky.
How's it going?
Just look. Around.
Your bike definitely needs some work, man. Bike's looking pretty busted. Let me know if you need anything.
What's going on? How's life?
Oh, okay. Hold on.
That's it.
That's all, huh?
Hey there.
Hey, Blair.
Good choice. Okay. That should work. All right. You have... Come back soon, huh?
Deke, I've been thinking about what you were saying about doing something to make a difference around here, pay back the camp.
I'm listening.
Do you got a few minutes? I want to show you something.
Yeah, guess I can spare you a minute or two.
So where are we heading? You ever been out to the caves north of the lake?
I know. Come on, see if you can keep up.
Okay, let's go.
I got marsh duty anyway this morning. Gotta see if any freaks are stuck in the muck up that way.
When's the last time you went up there?
Been a few years, I guess. When I was a boy, we used to live in that damn cave. My old man sort of fancied himself a geologist.
Sounds like we got a couple. Freaks stuck in the mud, I mean.
Yeah, sounds like. Here, let me take care of them.
All right.
Okay, you were saying?
All right. I guess I can let you. Nice work. I think Schizo's just found a new man for the job.
You know what Schizo can go do.
Anyway, as I was saying, I spent hours talking about how all these caves were formed when lava flows would harden on the outside, but the molten cores would still flow like buried rivers. You got the big caves that drew in the tourists, like Metolius up there. There's way more than that. Riddled all over these parts.
Okay, we're coming up on the highway. We gotta be quiet.
Jesus Christ! This is why you brought me out here? Smell a bunch of goddamn freaks?
Yeah. Okay. Come on, follow him.
Wait. Follow him? Where the hell are we going?
You'll see. Come on. Don't get too close. Stay down.
What the hell are we doing, Deke? This doesn't seem all that smart, even for a goddamn drifter.
Hold up. You remember telling me about how the tourists used to flood up from California in the summer, choke off Highway 97 and the I-5 freeway?
Yeah, in July, folks smelled almost as bad as these here freaks.
Well, you weren't wrong about one thing. These freaks, the big groups, the ones that some call hordes, I think they're the reason we can't get their numbers down.
What do you mean?
Think about it, man. I've been out here in the shit collecting bounties for more than a year. Boozer 2, Ricky, Schizo, a few others. How many freaks you think I killed?
A few.
Yeah, but their numbers never go down.
You got a point?
It's these hordes. Every night, there's a steady stream of them up and down the Sanium Highway. Thousands of freaks pouring into the Lost Lake Valley north of the Cascades.
And you think they're coming up from California? Highway's closed off. No one's been south of the Sanium Pass in years.
It's not closed off to the hordes. Freaks are the reason it's closed off. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make is that the hordes come in every night. Not a goddamn thing we can do to stop them.
You got that much right. Lost more than a few men trying to back in the day.
Yeah, I know. I was there. And every horde that comes through leaves a few stragglers or gets busted up and scatters and just like that, freaks everywhere as far as the eye can see.
You don't need to see them to know that they're around.
We figure out a way to stop the hordes coming through. Maybe we can make some headway, reduce their numbers.
Make it safer. Free up more farmland, irrigation.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do we do that? You know goddamn well you can't take on a whatever you call it, a horde.
This is how.
I'll be goddamn.
Here now. They stand there all day, hibernating or whatever the hell freaks do.
So what are you thinking that we...
Yep. Blow it the hell up. Stick a dynamite there, there, and there. We bring down a mountain of rock. We seal this shit up.
Yeah, so we trap a few hundred inside. What good is that gonna do?
No, you don't get it. We seal this cave. Maybe they don't got no place to sleep. Or maybe this trail of piss and shit dries out, goes stale, and others stop coming.
Yeah. All right. All right. You get my attention. Okay, come on, let's head back.
All right, my knees are warmed up a bit. Let's see if you can keep up.
Yeah, okay.
Tell me, when does being out in the shit make you an expert on freaks? You spend your spare time just following them around, seeing what makes them tick?
Not exactly.
And how do you know about all this? About what a horde's gonna do, where they sleep?
A few days ago, I was riding north of Belknap Crater when a chopper flew by.
A chopper? What the hell?
Just listen to me. It was a black chopper. One of those Nero choppers that used to fly all over the goddamn place when the shit was going down.
And you saw one? Still?
I followed him. I stole one of their radios. I've been trying to track him down, see if they have a base around here. Supplies. Shit, I mean, see if the feds are still alive. You know what I'm saying? They're out here doing field work of some kind on the freaks. They're studying them.
They got resources to do that while we're out here starving, fighting to stay alive.
I followed them up to the Grotto Caves. You know the ones?
Yeah.
They had motion sensors set up, measuring how many freaks used the cave during the day, and, Mike, it was thousands.
That right.
They said freaks all up and down the Cascade Range, south of Crater Lake, and north up to Smith Rock all used these lava tube caves to hibernate. So, we blew up those caves. Maybe we have a few less to deal with.
Hey, this idea of yours, it's got some merit, but a job like that, it's gonna take a fair amount of TNT.
He said you wanted help making Lost Lake safer. This is how we do it.
All right. All right, look. There's some things I gotta do, okay? But you meet me at the bridge in a couple of minutes. I know where we can find some.
St. John. You were supposed to be up at the farm an hour ago. My guy said he's got a shovel waiting for you.
Yeah, Schizo, about that, I'm busy. See? Iron Mike and I, we're just heading out on a run.
You and Iron Mike? You'll get your ass up that way today, or you and your gimp boyfriend are gonna find yourselves out in the shit. You hear me? Without a goddamn paddle!
Yeah, I'll get right on that. St. John out.
What do you want?
You got something to say about it?
Can I help you?
Nope.
Hello.
Hey, how's it going?
All right. See you later.
Ready? Where are we headed? This time you're gonna have to trust me. Okay, where are we going?
You know what they used to mine all around these parts?
Yeah, mercury or something.
That's right, cinnabar. They extracted mercury from cinnabar. Folks back east think it was gold mines out here and silver. Not so. Back in the early 1900s, cinnabar was worth more than gold. To operate the mine, you need TNT for expansion, blowing out new tunnels, clearing cave-ins, that sort of shit. And to own TNT, you had to register with the county, keep copies of the keys to all your lockboxes with the commissioner.
Wait, the county courthouse? Where the hell is that?
Thought you knew. It's in the old federal building.
The old federal building? The one in Sherman's camp? Jesus, Mike, what the hell? You told me... You told me that you were never setting foot in that place again.
Did I? I don't recall.
You were drunk right after Joe was killed.
Did I tell you why?
No.
Here! Turn right here! This is it!
Mike, the place is gonna be crawling. I don't think this is a good idea.
Weather holds, we'll be safe enough. All right. That there? It's the old federal building. That's where we're headed.
Let's not go looking for trouble. Stay out of the buildings. Come on. We gotta head over this way.
Where are we headed?
Just follow me. Key'll be on the commissioner.
And you know where he is? Where his body is?
Yeah, I think I do.
Yeah? Everybody got wiped out, man, woman, and child. Only a few got out, and you were one of them, right?
Only two got out. Me and Nora. But it wasn't the freaks that took us out.
What do you mean?
Here.
In. The ammo was gone. Two sides called a truce. A meeting. Right here. Oh, we knew what was coming. We knew what was coming and we were prepared. Fight didn't last long. But it was bad. They had ammunition left after all, and... well, they... oh, hell, you can see what they did. Like I said... two people walked out of this town after all was said and done. Some days, I wish to hell one of them wasn't me. Commissioner's over there in the bean counter suit. Go get the key so we can get the hell out of here.
You didn't give a damn about sealing the caves. You brought me here
Because you brought me here because you wanted me to see this.
Not true. All right, you got the key? We're gonna go get the maps to those mines, just like I said, and we're gonna get more than enough TNT to seal every cave in the valley.
Bullshit.
You are right about one thing. I'm not sorry you've seen it.
Not following you, Mike.
I am talking about the war that's coming. With the Rippers. The one that Schizo saw hot for. You think he cares how many die? On either side? Never mind. Come on, let's get this done.
Here's the door.
Place is locked up tight.
Locked tight.
Come on. Gotta find a way upstairs.
Smells like something died in here.
Newts. Yeah, I smell them. Bad business. Never much like kids. They always tended to get on my nerves. Was always a sore spot between me and my Elizabeth. God rest her soul.
You didn't like kids. Well, here I thought.
Okay. All right, this is it. Now we got maps to every mine in the county showing where they stored their dynamite. Okay, come on.
Hear that?
Yeah.
Weren't you expecting anyone?
Nope.
Do you have my back here?
Hey, I don't like starting trouble, but I'll finish it if I have to.
Stay behind me.
Hey, I can take care of myself.
I'm not saying you can't, but remember the last time that we were out in the shit.
Yeah, like I said, I'm staying behind you.
Guess not.
I thought I saw someone out there.
Jesus. up, old man.
Oh, yeah. I'm right behind you.
Jesus, what a mess!
Now you know why no one goes into Sherman's camp.
Eddie finds out you're out here risking your ass like this, she's gonna be pissed!
Now how would she find out about something like that?
Not from me.
About the Rippers, why you wanted me to see that shit?
No, Deke. I always saw a bit of myself in back in the day.
How's that?
Don't give a shit. Oh, you care about your friend. Don't want to see him die, but me? Any other goddamn person on the planet, I don't think so.
Caring will just get you killed.
Yeah, that's right. Thing is, not caring will get you killed just as easy. The good folks of Sherman Camp did will stop caring about anyone but themselves and their own. Easy to kill a man when he's just some piece of meat standing between you and what you need. Schizo wants to kill Rippers because he don't think they're human anymore. They don't count. They're standing in the way of what he wants. I don't buy into that shit. I won't have it.
You know, Schizo, he wonders why I'm a pacifist. That's what he likes to call me. He thinks I'm gonna get everybody killed.
Well, are you, Mike? Are you gonna get everyone killed?
Freaks aren't gonna be around forever. Now, when they're gone, we're gonna need some folks around here to help pick up the pieces. Hey, look, hey. I don't like Carlos and his Rippers any more than I like Tucker or Copeland and his goddamn truthers. All right, but here, look. Here's the thing, Deke. I'm not going out of my way to kill any of them. I've had my share of killing.
Even if Carlos comes for you?
My truce will hold. You can bet on that.
I used to be a cop, believe it or not. Did that well?
Well, Mike, I ain't gonna bet on that. Your truce ain't gonna hold. Now, for once, I agree with Schizo. The Rippers, they ain't human. Not anymore.
Got some bounties for me? Got some ears here, okay.
That's all I got today.
How's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
Yeah, good. Okay. Thanks for stopping by. Hey there.
Hey, Blair. How's life?
Hold on, I'll get this.
I wonder how Boozer's holding up. I guess I should go check on him. Hope he's awake.
Someone's at the gate.
Open the gate.
I know him. Hello.
What's going on, Blair?
How's it going, brother?
No, Deke. I don't know about you, but I could use a hand.
You lay down.
Yes, ma'am.
He can't have visitors just yet, but I could really use a hand.
Yeah, I'll see you later.
I'll be here. Hey, Doc, seriously, though. Will I be able to play piano after all this is over?
Very funny, William. Lay down.
Okay. I could play chopsticks. No, seriously, I could. I'd be like...
As you can see, he's going to be just fine. His fever's completely gone.
Good, that's good. All right, well, I got to go take care
Deacon,
of some shit.
Like I said before, William really does owe you his life.
Boozer doesn't owe me shit. I owe him.
Hey, I saved two more. Eddie and Mia would have died without those antibiotics. I just thought you should know.
Seems like he's getting better.
Hey, good to see you.
Hey, Blair.
Okay.
Get out of the way.
You would come back soon, huh?